Sight to witness.
Eric, 8 hours passed by like 8 minutes. I fell asleep on the chair, and the worst part, I kept having nightmares. They came back, roughly, and I couldn't put a stop to them. I guess it had something to do with my mother bargaining in and confessing about everything. Tough, huh? I tried to loose the thought off my mind, but I couldn't. It made me sick to my stomach, having to experience something like that again. I hate my mother to the bones. I used to hate my father too, but as I grew, I understood he wasn't in his best state. He kept doing drugs and get wasted. He had a tough life, for that I am sure of. My uncle, Don Massimo, had explained to me, my father went into post-traumatic stress and panic attacks at a young age because their father was abusive. He hit him once with a baseball stick on the head and cracked his skull a bit. Since then, my father was... I understand that life isn't fair to anyone, but we still make our own choices. I remember once, when I was 7 or maybe 8, my mother came home and witnessed how my father bit me and kicked me, and she didn't do anything about it. I used to scream and call out for help, but no one came to help me. My sister used to cry when she saw me bitten up, or when she witnessed my father biting me, but then he assured her that he was faking it. She believed him, of course. She was 4 years old back then. Which child wouldn't believe his parents? But that is now in the past. It doesn't matter anymore. I stood up and went to the bathroom, washed my face and did my issues. I headed back and saw Sanders going to Tucker's cabin. He went in and closed the door behind him. "We will land in 5 minutes," he announced, and I took care of the bags. I stared out the window and saw the skyscrapers from up here. They seemed like small buildings made of Lego. I opened my phone, but I still didn't have service. I waited until we landed. Sandler helped me out with the bags and went out. A black car, I think it must be an Audi SUV, was waiting outside. Sandler opened the door for me and I hopped in, right after I said my goodbyes to Tucker and congratulated him on the smooth landing. After we drove off, the roads didn't seem too full. It is 10 a.m. People are already working. The time zone is shitty. I hate it here. I have nothing against the place or people. It is just not my style. We headed to Massimo Hayward, which was an 1 hour way from the airport. I relaxed once again and checked my emails. I decided to call Jake and let him know I am in New York. I tried calling him, but he keeps going straight to his voicemail. I hate that shit. I emailed his PA that I was 40 minutes away, and she replied fast enough.
Mr. Massimo, Mr. Hayward is already on his way to Angel's Hearth. He wanted me to email it to you as soon as you landed. P.S. Your new assistant is here. She was available for the whole week. Samantha Ross, personal assistant of Jake Hayward.
Why do I always find out about things at the last minute with this man? He might be my colleague and friend, but he is such an ass sometimes. I tell Sandler about the new route he has to take, but then I remember that my new assistant is here. I will probably need her. Maybe it was to head to Massimo Hayward. Sandler nods when I tell him about the change of mind. In less than 5 minutes, we will be there. I write an email to Samantha and tell her to order the new assistant to wait in front of the building. She replies, "As we arrive, I climb out and look for the girl Samantha described to me. Hair in a ponytail, blonde, blue skirt, above the knees, and a white shirt. Let's see if I find someone who looks like her. There she is. My jaw dropped sight of her. She looks like a goddess on high heels. She looks up at me and immediately recognizes me. She comes close and holds out her hand at me. Her expression remains the same. No mesmerized face, no hooked eyes, no jaw dropping at the sight of me. She is professional, but even the professionals have a hard time to contain themselves. I don't like this a bit. I don't like it. That I want her to look at me like a lost puppy and to submit herself at me. I imagine her down on her knee bedroom, my cock in her mouth, her hair all over her shoulders. Fuck, what the hell is wrong with me? I shake that thought off and smile at her.
Hello, sir. I am Sophia Matthew, and I'm going to be your assistant for the week. I was informed you would like to go to Angel's Hearth and would like me to assist you.
Her voice sounds like heaven. She even smells good. Her touch is firm and cold. Damn, this girl is tough. Miss Matthew, I am Eric Massimo. Nice to meet you. I wanted to say more, but I stop myself before I say something I regret. No woman had this effect on me. Never. Not even the first woman I slept with. Amanda. She was a vision, yes. But she is a small dot in front of Sophia.
Shall we go, sir?
She asked me with a firm tone. After you, I said to her, wanting to see her behind, which, by the way, did not disappoint. What I could do to that ass. I slapped my conscience back to reality and focused on the now. Sophia was sitting right next to me, her beautiful rack hiding behind the shirt. Why would she hide her amazing rack? I guess because of perverts like me. I have issues, and I am sure Miss Sophia would help with that. Way through her nipples down to her sweet spot. Would want to kiss that throat, those full lips. She turned to look at me, and I had access to her beautiful green eyes. She is a goddess. I felt my length tighten my pants. Shit, this is not what I need right now. She didn't even blush when she saw I was looking at her. I don't have any effect. Nothing? That hurts, to be honest. I always found my way to a girl's panties, but with this one, I couldn't even find it past her eyes. She gives nothing away.
Sophia, I was waiting outside the building as instructed. I was wearing a blue skirt, length right above my knees, and a white shirt. My blue high heels matched my skirt, and my bag was big and black, made for carrying the paperwork. I kept looking around, trying to find the man I was looking for. I don't quite know him, but I only saw his picture. Samantha showed me. I turned to the left, and I saw the man standing on the sidewalk. He found me, too, and I walked towards him with a smile. He seemed a little bit uncomfortable, maybe because of the long trip. Hello, sir. I'm Sophia Matthew, and I'm going to be your assistant for the week. I was informed you would like to go to Angel's Hearth and would like me to assist you. I told him and held out my hand. He took it, shook it, and gawked at me for a second or two. I hope I don't look like an idiot right now. Now, is something wrong with me? Or why does he look at me like that? Now that I see him, he is very handsome. Yummy, I could say, but not my type. Either way, I'm with Chris, so I distract myself from that thought.
Miss Matthew, I am Eric Massimo. Nice to meet you.
Even his voice is sexy. Nice one. Well, he is my boss for a week, so nothing big. He stares at me like I'm a snack. He wishes. I am not a snack. I am a full meal, mister, along with the drink. Shall we go, sir? I said to him with a firm tone. I have to remain professional.
After you.
I smile at him for being so kind. Stop being so naive. He just wants to check you out. More specifically, your lady bum. I never thought of perverse stuff. I always took it the nice and kind way, like in the 80s. The men used to be so nice and gentle with the women, but my bitchy goddess inside of me always made everything about sex. Why, though? I climbed in the car and greeted the man who was driving. I made myself comfortable and Eric climbed into the car beside me. He didn't say a word the whole time we were in the car. I don't know why, but I had this urge to look at him, so I turned and watched him. He was looking at me. Ugh. I hate it when people look at me. It makes me self-conscious and my confidence drops at a very low level. I took my eyes off him and looked out of the window. I have been through this roads 1,000 times, but this time it felt different. Maybe because I was with Eric in the car and the tension could be cut with a knife? I have no idea, but erased that thought and remained calm.
Sir, we are here,
said the man who was driving the car.
Sanders, don't go too far. I will call you as soon as we are done.
The man nodded and then gave me a quick look from the mirror. He smiled at me and I smiled back. He seemed nice. The man beside me, not that much. He thinks he is the boss of the universe, when he actually isn't. But who am I to judge? I don't even know what he has been through to become who he is. My mother's words come back to mind. You should never judge a book by its cover, and never judge a person by his looks or first impression. Looks always lie, and impressions depend on how you treat the person. My mother is my best friend. I love it that I tell her everything. She is the best advisor and mother in the whole world. I really miss her.
Are you coming, Miss Matthew?
I heard the man say, and distracted me from my thoughts. Yes, sir. I'm right behind you.